A little higher.
Okay, one, two, three, go.
Oh boy. Well, it's more oscillatory than I expected. Whoa, look at that overly aggressive turn. Okay, I'm going to turn.
Yeah, so you had really low damping in that mode, but it did damp.
Eventually. Well, it made for more interesting video then, didn't it?
I'm waiting for the mid-air collision here.
Yeah, please don't hit me.
I think they're going to hit each other. Well, yeah, that's good. The difference in tip speed is going to excite the...
So, you still got our little list of things to try?
Hold it out.
This is not as stable as I'd hoped for, but it's not, you know...
Okay, so your first one was steady state full aileron turns against auto level. And I think you're already doing that, aren't you?
No. But let me work into it here. Okay, starting steady state full left, going gradually increasing the ailerons. Gradually increasing the ailerons, going up on throttle to keep.
And it's waving more and more.
Also holding almost full up elevator to do it.
Okay.
Oh, I backed off on the aileron accidentally, instinctively.
Okay, I'm thinking, let's call that enough for the moment.
The outboard.
Okay, coming back to level.
Now, you still got all the auto level on?
Yes, full auto level.
And if you go to the other P, that turns it off?
Yes.
Is that proportional?
Yes.
I would try backing off a little bit and see what happens.
Okay, backing off auto level now.
You know, be ready to shove it back on if you have to.
Okay, I'm at maybe half auto level right now.
Okay.
Whoa. The tip started to come up. That usually indicates a slip is developing. So it's not self-coordinating the turns. I'm having to do that somewhat manually.
Yeah, I'm not too surprised about that.
All right, so we need full auto level for now anyway. So what's one of the other ones we can try?
Drive a hard slip with full rudder and opposite aileron.
Oh, that's dangerous.
That's very dangerous.
I can see where that's going to...
You can't turn off one motor.
Not, no.
You can try gliding.
Okay.
Don't go all the way down.
Okay, reducing throttle, keeping the elevator constant, down to below half throttle now.
Yeah, don't go to full cutoff.
Yeah, because that'll lose my yaw stability.
Right.
It seems to naturally want to turn left for some reason, but that's okay because I like turning left.
Okay. Now that's looking a little bit better damped, actually.
Well, I'm almost at full idle. It's hard to tell by feel.
Right.
Going back up on throttle just to keep the airspeed up.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wonder if like the gain is too high for the outboard panels.
That may be.
That could well be. Yeah.
Okay, going back up to like 2/3 throttle.
Okay.
All right. There's the stall one, which is a little dangerous. But
right.
The reason we're here is to learn and
yeah, I'm tempted to say just. Don't push it more on this flight.
Well, yeah, but every landing is a risk, so let's get what we can out of it.
Okay, so the only other things that you can do here...
Oh, I can do the full left pulse, or the full aileron pulse.
You can do an aileron pulse.
Okay, so aileron pulse now.
Whoa.
Aileron
wow.
Pulse to the right. That's, I kind of expected that.
Do that again?
I will.
Yeah, they just do it so the pieces fall over the field.
Understood.
And I'll need to land pretty soon. How much longer do you have?
Oh, I have time.
Okay, so I can swap batteries and then capture them.
Well, maybe.
I'll be there.
Okay, full aileron pulse to the left now. Let's do that again where I can see it from the trailing edge now. Yeah, that kind of S-curve thing was kind of expected.
Okay, so you're at what throttle now?
I'm at 2/3 throttle maybe.
Okay, why don't you try the same thing at about 1/3 throttle?
Okay. Let me set it up though.
Yeah, set it up where we can see it.
Okay, coming around the corner at 1/3 throttle. Actually, that's more like half. Okay, leveling out. Aileron pulse to the right. Yeah, more damped. Pulse to the right, more damped.
Okay, that was a worthwhile experiment.
Okay, so the other thing we haven't done is tried full auto level, full up elevator, reducing throttle till it stalls. That's dangerous, but
okay.
We got to learn somehow, right?
Right.
Okay, but we don't have our in-air video. Well, we've got our ground video. I think we should keep moving because we'll run out of battery. I don't know how quick Tim can get back up.
Yeah, he ran back. He's putting a battery in. Okay.
These batteries will last kind of a long time on this thing.
Yeah, but
it's relative.
You don't want to lose one.
No, no. Although, well, we do eventually, but not now.
Right.
So okay. It does seem to be happier at lower throttle settings. That's so maybe that'll actually help us. Well, just waiting for Tim then. All right. You know what I could do is an elevator pulse too.
Okay.
It's kind of a non-event.
Yeah.
That was full up elevator. There's full down elevator. Also mostly a non-event.
Tim's here.
Wait for him to get into the air. Okay, Tim, yep.
He is now.
Okay. Straight out in front of you.
Turn to your right a little bit.
Let me know when you're on station. Okay. Getting ready to do an aileron pulse?
That looks so weird from this perspective.
Okay, now an aileron pulse at lower throttle. More damped. Okay, now I just got to make the turn.
I'm trying not to get so close so that it keeps the whole thing.
Yeah, and it's safer that way. Okay, getting ready to do the low throttle. Well, let's start feeding up elevator and reducing throttle. This could get ugly here, folks. Feeding an up elevator, feeding an up elevator, full low throttle. Whoops, I said I wasn't going to do that, which is why I lost yaw control, because I was at full idle.
Yeah.
I forgot about that.
Okay, but nothing.
But nothing happened.
Nothing weird there.
Nothing bad happened at all.
Okay, wind up turn at high power and high bank angle against partial auto level.
Well, I think we've already gone as far as we can, even against full auto level, because it at high power,
right.
It starts to get ugly.
Now, let's see, have you been at full auto level recently, or are you still at half?
I'll tell you what, I just took off a portion of the auto level. I'm starting to wind up the turn. Going up to more and more ailerons, feeding in rudder as well. I'm at full rudder now, and feeding in ailerons to go with.
Whoa.
That's doing much better.
Yeah, it's starting to lose it on the inside tip. Okay,
right,
that's as far as I can
go
with
you
that.
Had that inside tip almost stops.
I know.
I have some airflow to hold it up.
So that, yeah, exactly.
So what auto level was that at?
That was at maybe 50%. It's hard to tell by feel. You could look at the switch in the back, but.
Yeah, you're somewhere around 50.
Okay, so what else is there to do? Anything else on the list?
There's nothing else here that you can do without changing program.
Okay, so Tim, I'm going to do an elevator pulse. I don't think you've seen one of those.
Now, the only other thing would be completely go off on the auto level.
Okay. All right, let's try that. Let's do that. I'm going to turn around so I'm not headed towards the trees. I think it wants to turn left when I do that. So going off on auto level now. That's full auto level off.
Okay, go back on.
Going back on. It's not a great idea, but it doesn't immediately fall out of the sky.
Right.
Let's do a full idle for, since we now know that it'll do it. This is with auto level, but at low throttle. And then we're going to land because I don't know how much battery we got left.
Okay, you have a slight wind from your right. Very
slight. I hear you.
It doesn't matter which way you land.
Okay. So going to full idle now. Full idle, that is full idle right there, full idle. And you see it wants to go into a left-hand turn. But no harm, coming up on the power now and turning around, setting up a landing approach. It doesn't feel like I have as much power as I did before. So now is a good time to start landing. I realize I don't want to hit those trees over there.
Yeah.
I think I can turn tight enough to not be.
You can totally turn tight enough. The wind has shifted, it's now a little bit behind us.
Right.
Not enough to matter.
Well, part of the problem is I lose some yaw authority as I go to lower and lower throttle settings.
Right.
I'm this side of the trees, I think.
I think you are too.
Yep, you are.
So, yeah, you're good.
I'm good now. Coming up on throttle. Leveling. Yeah, that turned tighter than I expected, actually.
Okay.
Whoa. Pull up elevator. What we really need is airspeed adjustable gains. Now,
you put it this way, you always need airspeed adjustable gains.
Okay, let's just keep gentle tension and walk it back.
You want to take it all the way back up to the area?
No, because I can't put it on the bench.
Okay.
And it's easier on my knees to take it apart in the grass. So let's just take it back to where we started.